What is going on, NCK? Yeah, Death Star 18 here. Welcome back to the Knights Roundtable podcast. Today I'm here with Shadows and Dragon, aka the person behind me. Yep, I'm here with Bionicle, again, person behind me.
Kinda nauseous, rude.
Get back here, boy.
And Rage Ninja. Say hello.
Hey guys, how's it going?
So, we have a list to talk about, as is always. I'll open the floor to you guys first. Also, we all hope that you're having a wonderful day. This is the beginning of vacation. So fun. By vacation, I mean vacation for the lack of YouTube videos, because there will be more YouTube videos coming out in the future. So, first item on the list. Games coming out this year. And we have Halo Wars 2, which just came out. So I'll open the floor to you guys. What do we think?
Well, I don't play Halo Wars 2, so I don't know. This is kind of up to you two.
And mine's literally still stalling.
You go first.
Going off my experience of the Halo Wars 2.
Injustice 2.
So far, it's fun.
I don't play Injustice 2.
I don't know. Do you think it'll be good?
No.
I didn't even like the first Injustice, so I don't know.
Look, I'm gonna buy it, but
really?
I'm not gonna keep it.
Okay, moving
I'll
on.
I'll take it off you for nothing.
Honor.
Hey, now that's a game I can get behind.
Now that was a good game. Sorry, that
mate,
is a good
it was
game,
fun.
I think. I'm installing it as we speak.
Yeah,
so.
No, you played it next week.
Yeah.
Actually, bang it in 2 weeks.
I have to say, I don't remember a game that like made combat that looked complex so simple. Honestly, it felt like a dumbed down version of Mortal Kombat mixed with Smite. It was nice. I'm gonna be honest, it is nice. I enjoy like the combat system.
It was good. Hashtag Samurai the best, but it was good.
Wrong. actually, I was talking with the guy at the place where I got the game. And I said, so, you, can I get a copy of For Honor? And he goes, no. I go, no? He goes, no, we're all out. I go, really? He goes, yeah, we just sold the last one this morning. He goes, the issue is, and this made sense after he explained it, nobody cares about the game. This game was so poorly advertised in the beginning. And they said, to get hype, what are we going to do? We're going to send out a beta right before the game gets launched. So what do? They have the beta for 3 days, and in 3 days after that, the game is launched. Great! Awesome for them! Hype! Issue is, they send out the amount of copies for a game center to have based on pre-orders and initial launch date. So if three people order the pre-order the regular edition, they're going to get five copies, two extra, three for the three pre-orders. Issue is, since
that's
nobody...
That's why you couldn't find the regular edition.
Exactly! Since nobody had time to pre-order because the beta, which just piqued everybody's interest, had been right before launched.
Now,
guess what? Nobody pre-ordered because there was no point. Therefore, no place had enough copies. So it's like Ubisoft.
Beth.
And whoever else. Why? What?
Beth. You're wrong.
I'm not wrong.
Actually,
not. Not wrong.
You're wrong. No, in 2016 E3 was advertised and a load of people did play it, and a lot of gamers were keeping their eyes on it. It's just that, obviously, unfortunately for your area, most people didn't know about it, because I've known about it for the past year now.
Okay, when you say your area, don't forget, you're in a different country, okay? You're in a different country than me.
Hey, literally.
Sounds like a personal problem.
Hey, listen. I'm not
okay, Navi.
Navi, don't worry. I'm not Navi, don't worry. But, no, this is actually told to me by an American person. So, yeah, fight me, scrub.
Sure.
360 no-scope you.
Bring your lunch.
Huh.
Your arrow disappeared. Anyways, that's you. Okay. That's an issue across the board, really, though. So. Oh, well, it is what it is. Moving on from four beta. Yes, four beta. So happy I can English. Red Dead Redemption 2.
Great.
I know little to nothing about this game. What do you guys think?
Never play the first one.
You
not gonna
fudger.
Like
I hope you
Red Dead Redemption.
I played the first one, was fun. Why is there still so much smoke on the table?
I actually don't know.
Smoke.
Because I'm smoking the joint. Right.
Sweet. Anyways.
It's joking. Sorry, guys. Joke is bad.
Red Dead Redemption
but
was.
No, actually, I have hopes for.
Yeah, I do too.
Oh.
Whoa.
I have hopes for it.
It was an excellent game. I don't know what they're going to do with story unless if it's like a prequel to the first
game. Well, it's either going to be a prequel. Or, yeah, or they continue on from the story because John Boston killed the.
Yeah, but like.
His father's murderer, didn't he?
What is there to tell with Jack? Like, the kid saw his father get murdered because of a gang that he was once with by the U.S. Federal Army.
I know,
Army.
But it's
like what? Where
idea.
Did go?
It's he like,
had,
it's...
He's had children.
It's Rockstar. They'll go in all
he
directions.
Dies, repeats.
I don't know.
It's like, if you make the mistakes of the past is doomed to repeat itself. He's killed a federal figure, or like a person with immense power. He killed him, and now he has to be on the run because, again, he's killed someone with a lot of power behind him.
I guess.
I mean that.
Makes sense.
I mean that stuff. It's kind of like this, like when Abraham Lincoln was shot in the back of the head. No one rolled their eyes and said, "Oh, it's just another Monday." No, they were really pissed off about it, even back
then.
Well,
some people were happy.
I thought it was another Monday.
It's a person with power. So, I'm assuming he's going to be on the run from the authorities.
I guess that makes sense.
I think that's how the story's going to go.
I guess that makes sense. Either that or a prequel showing John in the gang, I think, would be probably the second best thing you're doing.
I don't know, I thought that was funny.
Anyways, moving on. Crash Bandicoot! Crash Bandicoot Remastered for PlayStation!
Yeah, absolutely love it. Don't even own a PlayStation.
One problem, though. It has to be on the fucking PlayStation.
Well,
doesn't
yeah,
it?
That
like it can't be on multi-platform. No, just asked it. I'm not salty. You are. Salt.
I'm actually really excited. My brother has a PlayStation 4, and he pre-ordered the new Crash Bandicoot. Turns out, I guess they're also including Wrath of Cortex, which was my childhood on the GameCube, basically. So
why
I mean,
include Wrath of Cortex?
Because it's an awesome game that deserves everything. So shut up.
Really?
I will murder your flipping face.
We're in punching difference.
The first three are classics. Wrath of Cortex wasn't so greatly received.
Critics are wrong. People are right. You two don't kill each other yet.
It's a combination of people. The people didn't enjoy it too much, and critics weren't really that pleased with it.
I hate you
both. Hey, look
at that,
they killed each other.
I hate you both so much.
I'm sorry, we had to, but whatever.
What about you, Bionicle? What do you think?
As soon as he gets back here.
Brilliant game. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, now all you have to do is get a PlayStation 4.
That's why I'm not buying one. I'm just going to go to a friend's house and play it.
Fair
enough. I'm gonna steal my mate's PS4. If you're watching that, by the way, friend, I don't know if you are. You know who you are. I'm coming around.
If it's the person who I think you're thinking of, then I'm also gonna play as Persona 5.
Yeah.
Probably Jordan! Not, but yes. Sure.
Okay.
I don't know.
Let's say that you know.
Have you guys heard about the word? No, have you guys heard about the Portal movie?
No,
I haven't actually.
Not.
This is the one thing I haven't heard about.
Take that back.
So, the most recent news I've heard, J.J. Abrams most likely will be director of the movie, I think. But either way, they are most likely creating a Portal movie. What do we think about that? You guys have to have an opinion on that. You have to.
Okay.
I have faith.
I think the one problem I have.
I hope they don't fuck up the Portal franchise.
The one problem I have with it is that video games that transition into movies don't go well because
Assassin's Creed.
It's exactly Angry Birds.
Great example. Oh, that shouldn't have ever happened.
Anyway, But the reason why it never works well is because at first it was a video game where you can interact with it. It's now a movie that kind of gives less. In my opinion, movies always tend to give less. Not only that, but Paul, though it does have a good story, it doesn't have, like, the story's never really been much of a main focus. Like, it was always more of, like, a comedy type of story than anything that great.
If they made it as a comedy...
People usually went there for the puzzle games.
So if they did it as a comedy story, I think they'd get away with it. But it wasn't, like, any main canon storyline. It was just someone new we'd follow in a movie.
You just get to see GLaDOS being turned into a potato.
Yay!
And
best
that's
character!
That's the entire movie. It's just GLaDOS being turned into a potato over and over again for 2 hours.
To be fair, the way they could actually make the movie potentially good is if they actually make it so it's one, the character actually learns puzzles and stuff in the games.
Puzzles.
I kind of disagree because character development in a Portal movie, unless it's the robots like GLaDOS, do you even know who, I barely even know the main character's fucking name. I don't even know who the player is. All I know is that she's a female.
Carol.
That's all I know.
Okay.
That she's just stuck here.
Now, what if J.J. Abrams is a director? Remember, he directed Star Trek Into Darkness and Star Wars.
Oh, God.
He directed Star Wars for The Force Awakens and stuff like that. The good movies.
Oh.
The good movies.
Some.
I never liked Star Trek,
but
okay.
Some faith?
Some faith.
As much faith as I do in the character Faith from The Mirror Edgers.
I'm sure that he could do this right so long as he's decent at comedy, because you can't take Portal seriously. If you're promising cake,
I think you can.
You can't.
GLaDOS gives you the irony that makes it amusing.
You can make Portal into all about humanity and how there was like this awful event, and Shell is part of this experiment involving the leftover human race in which they have to be able to be adaptable. Yes, they have to be adaptable to puzzles in the above world using a portal gun.
I'm just giving an example
of how you can take it seriously.
This is what I will do when I enter the cinema to see it.
Okay, but what the
heck?
Let me tell you why that would fail. It's because it wouldn't be a Portal movie. Portal is like this really...
Solving puzzles with the portal gun.
It wouldn't, though. Yeah, but you need more than that in a movie.
You have GLaDOS being like the person who commands the test, and you have Wheatley being the sinking random savior of the day, and turns out, evil.
We all know that GLaDOS is the most edgiest thing since Shadow the Hedgehog. I mean,
She has a tragic backstory.
No.
I mean, it could work.
You see, Joe.
Yeah.
Shadow the Hedgehog. And Reaper put into one.
Ooh.
What are you...
So edgy, I can cut myself on it.
What?
But no, what I'm saying is that a serious story with Portal would fall apart quicker.
I tend to
fall apart quicker than DC's cinematic universe.
Oh, God. You cannot fall apart quicker than that.
It would,
but I disagree.
Why?
You have
the
Mary... Not Mary Sue. The stinking... What do you call it? The character that, betrays the main character. The character that controls the main character becomes the main character's friend.
Yeah, but that's done in a funny way.
Why does it have to be funny? It doesn't have to be funny. It could be a serious movie.
Death. No, it can't be. Because Paul is not serious. But on the circuit... Alright, Death, what did you think of the Assassin's Creed movie?
Didn't see it. Don't care to. I never liked Assassin's Creed to begin with.
Yeah, I didn't see it either.
Oh, okay. Well, in that case,
all I knew was shit.
Yeah, it's shit. Don't.
Well, I mean, when you're dealing with something as complex as being able to hack into the human mind, go back in time, play as the actual real person, and then go back in time, and apparently that affected the present, that can't be done in a movie. You have to explain that in like a 10-hour session.
The theory's been explored, but there's no real merit to looking through your memories with DNA.
Agreed.
Anyway, back to like...
Go back in the chat.
Back to your serious argument with Portal. I don't think it could work because, again, Sirius just wouldn't go well. It's in a post-apocalyptic world, yes. The setting's there. yes, but the characters, the setup, I mean, you wield a portal gun, where an orange portal means you go in this direction, and a blue one means you go through this direction.
It's
like,
symbolism!
Realism and seriousness kind of what got booted out of the window as soon as the concept was thought of. And GLaDOS and the... I don't know, what's the blue one called again?
Wheatley.
Wheatley!
GLaDOS and Wheatley...
You and make puns along the way.
Yeah, GLaDOS and Wheatley could not be serious characters.
Yes, they can.
It ruined the entire vibe.
They were serious
unless they bring
in
a new
game.
Character.
I have a serious line of dialogue to say now.
Yes,
yeah,
they
exactly!
Were.
No, they weren't. They were as about
GLaDOS,
as edgy
oh,
as
GLaDOS. No, GLaDOS was an emotionally attached robot that was originally a human being, but then was abused and used by Cage. It was uploaded into a system. Wheatley is this AI that seems to be pretty, like, programmed to be human, but ends up actually getting addicted
Wheatley
to power and ends up backstabbing the actual main character. They're serious characters with
Wheatley
backstories
was...
that are pretty heavy.
Yeah, but it wouldn't work, though. It's not Portal. The problem is with a video game transitioning into a movie is that you've got to hold the story and the vibe intact. And if you break that vibe, then you've essentially... it can't be called a Portal movie. It just can't. It's
if
like,
they
I don't know,
it
let's
like
see.
Rogue One, I think that could work. A serious movie with comic relief is what I mean. Like... Okay. Good spoiling. I'm glad
you're welcome. You're welcome, guys.
No.
I've ruined everything.
You've killed all the Padawans.
No. But no, it wouldn't work. I'm sorry, but it just wouldn't. Like, it'd fail as a Portal movie if it did went through there. Because it worked just about as well as the new Batman vs. Superman movie.
My issue with that movie, if you want to talk about this, my issue is that was not Batman.
I didn't really
want to
Batman, talk about it, I was just
Batman,
comparing it for hyperbole.
Batman does not kill people or torture people or hurt people. He goes in, does what he needs to do, get out and save the day. This Batman was a psychopath who, would you get back in here, was a psychopath who tortured every single person who could possibly lead him to an answer for the guy
steak.
He was trying to find. Which in the end, the guy wasn't even a real bad guy, but Batman was so focused on what he wanted instead of what reality was that he did not think about it.
Death.
Unlike the regular Batman from the regular movies. That's my issue.
Death.
As a regular movie and a superhero movie, it was really just up there with Civil War, in my opinion. As a Batman movie, or even half a Batman movie, it was awful and terrible. And, oh, how do they make up because their mother's names are Martha? Are you flipping kidding me? What kind of stinking awful fishhook of an escape is that?
Death.
Anyways.
You're ranting. Def, I get where you're coming from, but I didn't really bring up the subject. I was just comparing it for comedy. But anyway, moving on. What other subjects would you like to talk about?
Well, while we're on the subject of movies,
do
we
still have an
hour
left?
I don't know, do we?
Yeah, we have some. We have The Last Jedi.
Yeah, that's all I know. That it's called The Last
okay,
Jedi
then.
And the text is red instead of...
That's
where
the
do you think they're
going to
go?
I think
where
this is going to be
the story for Last Jedi.
I'm excited.
Go.
I think it's going to be
too.
One of the darker films because it's... But the title, the text is red, and the only other Star Wars films that have text red.
I swear to God, though, if
five
Rey's
and three.
Hands get, if Rey, ha- if Rey gets her hand
Rey
chopped off and if she falls down Cloud City,
won't.
I'm gonna
really.
Get salty.
She's not gonna do that.
And if Vader just goes up to her, I am
the issue was JJ was damned if he did, damned if he didn't. He had to stick with the original storyline, but change a couple things here and there. Just to keep people reinvigorated about the new company in charge of Star Wars.
No,
he had to do what he had to do. He had to do what he
I
did.
I get why he did it with the first one. Just don't do it with the second one.
Well, he's not. He's only a co-director for this, really. So it's not even like he's at the helm of it. So it's going to be a new director
oh,
with
boy.
New ideas. So I have faith.
I hope.
I have faith. That said, I did hope. You guys hear about the I break hope. Today? The leak. Well, not really a leak, but the thing that's making us all question reality.
Wait, people have vegetables? Where?
I'm gonna hit you. The official Spain Twitter account of Star Wars, I think it was Spain, tweeted out something about The Last Jedi. It said, like, Lastos Ultimatos Jedi's, which basically, my point is that it said Ultimatos or something like that. Basically meaning The Last Jedi's with an S. So we've been so focused on figuring out who The Last Jedi is that we've been looking at this totally wrong in the English form. Instead, it could be meaning The Last Jedi, as in plural. Because don't forget, sheep is plural of sheep, fish plural of fish, Jedi is plural of Jedi. So, when it says The Last Jedi, and that's referencing to two or more, what could that mean for the movie?
I don't know, Luke and Rey are going to bite the bucket.
Ah, uh-huh. I mean, that's where the theories start coming in. Because you got the last Jedi, Luke and Rey, throughout the whole movie. Let's say that Luke kicks the bucket, as he most likely will, let's be honest. I'm not going to keep us singing, what is he, 70, 80-year-old guy on, or is he 60? I don't know. Either way, an older guy on board for a film that's going to require a lot of physical acting. So, he's probably going to kick the bucket. In the film, obviously, not actually Mark Hamill, but Luke Skywalker.
Hey, Death. It's called the stunt actor.
Yeah, but that's stupid. And then they're going to have Rey being the last Jedi, like, singular. But what about John Boyega? What about FN2187, traitor? What about Finn? Could he be a Jedi? He's already wielded Luke Skywalker's lightsaber.
No.
Don't forget, he wielded Luke Skywalker's lightsaber. And he could be Luke Skywalker's son. I think I talked about this.
Well, anyone can do that.
Skywalker's son.
Besides, he has training in close quarters combat with a weapon. Remember those stun batons? All of the troopers are designed to train them. They're also trained to use certain other melee weapons as well. So him using a lightsaber isn't too far fetched.
No.
I can even swing one around.
Well. And what about him being Luke Skywalker's son? Do you think that's a possibility?
God, no.
I think there's a possibility.
But my thing,
wait, you mean Finn being Luke Skywalker's son?
Yes! Yes!
Finn. Luke Skywalker's son.
Yes! Finn. I think there's a possibility.
Finn. All I'm saying is his head
Luke Skywalker's
like,
son.
Do flip.
Yes.
Yeah, I see his head constantly doing flips. It's disturbing.
Def, don't you see like a wee issue with that?
I do, but my rebuttal is that the main person of that color is Lando Calrissian of what we're aware of. However, does not mean that there are not other people of the same color. Therefore, if there is a black woman in the Star Wars universe that Luke Skywalker meets and has a kid with, it's not too far-fetched to assume that Finn could be Luke's son. He already wielded his lightsaber. He's already probably in tune with the Force. If that's the case, what does that mean for the actual storyline? That means that Luke Skywalker's son literally joined the new Empire. Would you stop and get out of here? And how big of a plot twist is that? Huh?
Stop. Listen to this theory that's just popped into my head. It's probably already been theorized. Being as Kylo Ren actually is Leia's and Solo's son, he has some of the light side, hence why he, in the Jedi, in
oh god, that was
seven,
a...
he says
funny.
That he feels it, the light, the whatever.
Right,
he has some light,
but
he's
making what if? Don't forget.
Might decide to join him.
Don't forget though that Finn had actually gotten into a fight with Kylo Ren. If Finn got in a fight with Kylo Ren, that means Luke Skywalker's family and the Solo family were fighting. That is monumental in the Star Wars universe. And if that is the case where they almost killed each other, Luke Skywalker's son almost killed Han Solo's son.
Speaking of killing each
other, that's mind blowing. That's mind-blowing!
I'm finally dead.
Death, listen here. I know you probably want it to happen, but you have the itsy-bitsy slight problem that, Luke is a completely different ethnicity to, Finn.
But there are women in the universe
not
of
only
Star
that,
Wars!
Not only that,
he's also been living on an island for fuck knows how many years. With a rock.
Okay, yeah,
not
but that was
that,
like years after
Finn was taken from his home taken from his home, mind you, by these by the First Legion. Taken.
Right. Well,
where the fuck was Luke during
that? Rey was left behind. What if? What if both Rey and Finn? No, okay, that's a bit much. But what if? Okay, it's not that far fetched to assume that Rey's parents, as in it was shown, had left her on the planet. So why would we not be surprised to see that Finn's parents left him on a planet with like a thing in a like Harry Potter, where he had a fat uncle and a fat cousin and a fat mother. Well, actually, mother wasn't that fat in Harry Potter.
Aside from throwing genetic engineering completely out the window, you've also got the problem that Finn would have been taken when he was just but a wee child, as in a few months old. Rey was left behind when she was about 3 or 6.
So
don't you think
issue?
That a guy, if I was a Jedi and wield the power of the Force and I had a damn lightsaber and I saw someone trying to take my kid, I'd probably grab that fucking thing and disintegrate the fucker.
Not like, if you didn't know your son was in trouble.
Up until there was nothing left of him. How did I can sense him. It's called the Force. I attach my, like, when Luke and, when Anakin and Obi-Wan were fighting, they could feel each other. They can protect each other. That's what she said.
Okay, true. And I will agree with you. And I will say that, Leia, I was about to say Padme, Leia had felt when Han died. However, what if, alright, now Snoke and Ren obviously know about the history of Skywalker, Luke. I mean, it's obvious. Thinking Skywalker tried to teach Kylo Ren before he became Kylo Ren. However, what if that Finn was stolen from his adopted family, Luke had gone in, tried to save him, failed, went back, that was after Kylo, like, during the time when Kylo Ren was trying to, like, kill all his other Padawans and betrayed him, and Luke was like, oh, shoot, you know, my student just betrayed me, now they stole my son, I gotta go, and Luke, like, got up into a ship, vroom, through the universe, and went over, tried to save Finn, failed, almost died, went back to the planet, thought, I failed at teaching a new Jedi, I failed at teaching my class, all my guys are dead, my kid was stolen from me, everybody hates me, I'm gonna hide out here for another 20 years. Why is that so hard to believe?
So Connor, story of the last of the 8th movie. What do you think it's going to be like?
Oh, you know, I think it's going to be great. Everyone's going to die in a screaming fashion.
Yay!
And finally going to realize.
Sounds great. Sounds great. Moving on. Issue with PewDiePie.
Great.
Let's go.
What's the issue with PewDiePie? I don't watch him.
No.
Whoa. Eliminated. All right. Oh, he's back. Issue PewDiePie.
Fatality.
I'm just saying, Finn might be Luke's son. Okay, moving on. Issue PewDiePie actually does go a bit deeper than just PewDiePie being dumb. But, no offense to him. I'm not talking about him as personality. I'm talking him as, like, making those jokes. Him making those jokes was pretty stupid,
I'll
be honest. And it was
I don't know. That'd be pretty funny in my book.
Yeah, but here's the issue. When you're the face of a website like this, and people have their lives, livelihoods, like, based on this website, and you're the person who basically represents them to the outside world, aka, like, the media, you really have to be kind of careful with, you know, what you do. Now, that said, I think that if the jokes were in context and people understood them, I don't think this outlash would have been as big as it was. For example, I think it was the Washington Post that broke the story of him making these anti-Semitic jokes, which, again, I think was pretty stupid. However, that said, he's also done some pretty stupid things in the past as well. And I'm shocked to even have found out through this that he was at all connected to Disney. But when the Journal had, Post had broke that he made these jokes, and they had a compilation. I haven't seen it, fair warning. But just the fact that they had a compilation of his jokes about this and said anti-Semitic and was, like, putting him down for what he made fun of and stuff like that, like, that's not right. Unless if they gave context and unless if they had explained each joke as during the video what the joke was about and let the audience viewer or reader, rather, instead of the viewer, understand the point of the joke, I don't think that the Journal or Post had the right to take it way out of context, say that this guy's an anti-Semitic, and then that gets his livelihood with Disney thrown out the window, YouTube stops his show on YouTube Red, and now they don't want anything to do with him, like, was he stupid for making these jokes? Yes. Were they bad jokes?
Welcome to the
rules. Were they awful jokes? Yes. Were they offensive? Probably. Should he have these repercussions? I think they're a little too harsh. And should the Washington Post / Journal had done what they did? Unless if they did it in the way that made the person reading the article, and unless it was unbiased, which, let's be honest, in the media nowadays, that's never going to happen. But unless it was unbiased, I don't think they should have done it that way. But I am not surprised that he got repercussions, and I think that he does deserve at least some repercussions, but maybe not to the extent that he has currently right now. How about you guys?
See, I just don't think he deserves any. Like, this is just way too much out of hand. I mean, they were jokes. Like, just jokes. You can literally sum them up like that.
I feel like I need to watch the video where he made these jokes, not just to actually understand the
content.
I'll get you up to speed. I'll get you up to speed, Kyle. He essentially made some really offensive jokes. Disney dumped him on the side like yesterday's curry. and now he's essentially in a wee bit of shit, but his fans are still staying behind him. Go.
Oh, okay.
It's happened before several other YouTubers, and they've had less repercussions.
Yep, there you go.
Yes, that's actually a very fair point. I feel like a lot of what's happening to him is really just because of how big his thing is. Like, if this had happened to if this happened to me, the Washington Post could have cared less. Like, I am yesterday's curry to a lot of the YouTube world.
I'd be like, deaf, racist? Yeah, probably.
No, I'm not racist. But that
well,
said,
deaf isn't, but we are.
You're not racist.
Nah, I'm joking.
But that said, I think there's a point to be made. He's the face of YouTube. He has 53 million subscribers, at least had. I don't know what his current count is at. Like, this guy has the most of any channel, and the guy was making millions of dollars every year off of just making stupid videos. Like, I mean, he's in a pretty good position to be in. That said, yeah, it's kind of stupid of him to do the stuff he did, just plainly because he's the face of YouTube. But at the same time, I still think people need to realize he's just a guy trying to make people laugh, and he's making bad jokes, but they're jokes nonetheless, and they have to realize that. But because the way that the media is in Washington Post or Journal, and it most likely twisted the story, and then that just already put people's mindsets, and Disney saw that he was going to start having a bad rap, and then they immediately dropped him, and then YouTube dropped him. Now everybody's dropping him, all because of one stupid biased journal? I don't think that's right. But I do think he should realize a lot of his jokes, which I think he does now, God bless him, that a lot of his jokes are going to have repercussions. And you have to be careful what you say on here, because you can't just say whatever you want and get away with it. There will be consequences. But I don't think they should be to the extent they have had.
Well, I just don't think there should be consequences like that in general, just for the simple fact of, again, it's a joke. I mean, I know that some people get offended, but deal with it. Offensive jokes are the best jokes.
That's the other thing, too.
Because
of
the funniest.
You have to be careful in today's society because of how soft people are nowadays. That's just a fact of life. If this had happened in the 40s and 50s, do you really think people would have given two stinking cares? No. I don't think so. Because of how the world is and all how people are, like, really easily offended,
Unlimited power.
What?
Sorry.
He had to. I understand.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, you get a steak.
Shadow, you're online.
Oh, no.
But anyway, so...
Shall we move on?
Any last thoughts? What do you think, Shadow?
Huh? What?
He's completely gone.
That's what I think about the whole PewDiePie situation. I have not been paying attention to it.
That's fine.
You haven't put your stake in the ground about it?
Yep, I haven't. Shit. Okay, I've got a great idea. I don't have a... let's try that again. Hopping idea about it. Oh shit, no, I'm flying into that. Ow. My legs.
Each cried.
Okay.
Terrible people.
Now, Moving on from that. You two, you Rage and Shadow, Bionicle, you're whatever. You two have Come back.
It's too late. It's too late, Death. You've hurt his feelings.
There you go. Shoot him. Now you Rage and Shadow
Got it.
No, we'll go for walkies. You've been on the channel.
We'll go for walkies. I promise nothing bad will happen to you.
Oh my god.
Well, look, you just happened to fall down the cliff.
Wow.
Anyway, you were saying.
Shadow's been here since the beginning. Rage, you're still a little bit newer, but not so much. But, Bionicle, you're the new kid on block. You'll get initiated. I want to be able to... I want to be able to get you guys more involved.
You can't run
and I don't know how to do that. So, what I'm thinking about, and let me know what you two think about this, and by uncle, we can get you involved as well.
Yay.
We start doing more live things for YouTube and Twitch, and we start focusing more on building a community between the platforms to be focused on YouTube and Twitch, but honestly mainly on YouTube just because that's where my focus is. I just don't know how to make it where you two are more of a big player in the channel. I don't know. What do you guys think?
Well, I mean, we could just... Great way. But we could just be in just more videos in general. Like, I'm willing to be in every single one of yours, if necessary.
Well, I know.
That's bugging me.
But...
Not only that...
Thank you.
But... I don't know, I mean, it's kind of what you have to say, because I've kind of lost my words.
I've
forgotten what I was going to say.
To get more involved with the channel, for me in Rage, the most easiest thing would be for you to do is probably set up more social media so we can start interacting with the community or so.
It's actually an excellent idea.
Right, where are the haters? I'll fight them on the side of the street.
Can I trust you guys with being careful with what you say and how you say it and when you say it and where you say it and what you say?
Yes.
Me?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Me? I see your head.
Yes. Connor? No. Me? Yes. Ow. Connor? No.
I think I would trust Bionicle before Connor.
It's true.
Oh my god, hefty on. Sorry. Oh, excuse me. Woo! Stay awake. Alright.
Dying.
The big thing is I want this channel to have more of a community. I want to be able to interact with you guys a lot more, as I've stated before. I do think I'm going to start maybe doing more social media in the future. Maybe. I will probably start doing more live stream stuff, but I think I'm going to change my art, my channel art, because I've had it for a couple of years. It was made by a fan. It's that person. I'll forever be grateful. But now that it's turned into what we have, like what the actual, now that it's transformed is what I'm saying. Like, that was made actually way back when I had like 70 subs, which is why it's even more amazing that it's still there. But with the art that I have, it's good, but I feel like it really kind of focuses too much on me at this point, and I want it to be more about you guys. So, I need to be able to take the art, transform it into more community-oriented stuff. Take the channel and maybe social media, more, make that more community-focused. Take the videos, be able to use that as the main medium through which I communicate with you guys. I need to be able to take all this and put it into, and that wasn't me, by the way, trying to get one of you to make me art. Please don't go out of your way to do that. If you want to, that's awesome, but I'm not asking you to do that whatsoever. Now, one of you three, if you want to hit me up with some arty art, you guys hit me up. You three, Bionicle, Raven.
I mean,
Hunter does a badger.
What?
Same, but
Shock is here.
Oh yeah, true.
I mean, what for like your art on the banner that you have, you know, like the little thing on top of your channel. What cool. you could have for it is that you could just have us four around a round table.
A single wooden table.
Oh, jeez.
In a giant fuck-off temple, but... Like, you could have a red and black ninja, you could have a guy who's dressed in Shadow Dragon scales, you could have a Bionicle armored up person, you can have a Death Star armored up person, you know what I mean? That's just a suggestion.
That's actually not that bad. Yeah, okay. And that would really
inspire
you guys.
Oh, and the temple can be Aztec.
Oh, Aztec, there you go.
Make some blood rituals on top.
And while we're on the subject of the channel, what about future? Why did I write down future series? Who suggested that? Was that you, Connor? Did you suggest future series?
Bad boy.
Yes.
Can you explain? I don't even know what that means personally. What do you mean? Expand.
Because don't forget, because you're doing the whole like the non-editing for your Frontier series and Halo Wars 2 series. We're doing. I think there is a one more series, isn't there, as well. Another one somewhere hiding in the plans.
Probably.
No. Probably. We've forgotten about it probably, and just like, oh yeah, that's a thing.
There is Vertigo.
There you go. That's what we. Are we? Is that still a thing? Is that still happening?
That's a thing.
You know, all that stuff.
That's actually a thing.
Yeah. Touch wood.
Wow. Okay.
It's been an entire year since we've done a Vertigo episode.
Yep. That it has. Shoot. Okay. We're gonna have to get the gang back together. Oh, man. Okay. Well, there is Vertigo. We're gonna have to iron that out, Shadow. In Rage, we're gonna have to iron that out. You're gonna have to somehow be involved, Rage. I'll figure it out.
Vertigo
is still a thing.
What's Vertigo?
It's our Halo 5 Machinima series, which we started.
Halo 5.
Yeah.
I don't own Halo 5.
You stupid
so.
Fudging
Sorry.
Fudger.
I'll tell you to see Jackson. I'll buy you one.
Yeah. Joe,
it's
go
like
buy
fucking,
one.
It's like £4.
Go buy one, Joe. I mean, okay, so there's Vertigo. There is For Honor. There is Halo Wars 2. What else is there? What can we do that's more channel-oriented, other than those? Spit out some ideas.
Live Q&A sessions on Twitch.
Yes, actually.
I
forgot about that.
I didn't.
What were you gonna say, Rage?
I mean, you could actually do a Q&A, like you suggested. I did answering any questions.
I did a Q&A once. And
how did that go?
Actually, very well. Believe it or not, actually went very well. Issue is,
sorry,
I don't
that's
have...
confidential, Kyle. Anyway, how's your sex life?
What? What, Kyle?
That was yours.
What was that?
It doesn't matter.
Something I got from a friend. Continue.
Okay. I guess I would have to make an announcement about Q&A session. I mean, I already did an announcement about a Q&A session once, and nobody said anything on that video. I'd have to promote it pretty heavily.
This is why you get social media death.
Yeah, good point. It's actually a very good point. Actually. Alright, I'll have to think about that later.
I do, he's thinking.
The use of Twitter and having you got, yeah, I could probably twist that around, make that work. Okay. Well, that's the list exhausted. What else do you guys have in your mind?
Giant.
Not
massive.
Horse throwing cock.
God damn it, I was trying to keep it clean. Also,
I broke
them off the rail, off the trails. I'm gonna take a swish of vodka because it can't be last moment.
I hate you. I hate you, Rage.
Oh, wait, that reminds me. big throbbing horse penis actually reminds him of something. Should be concerning, but it's not. We could do that Cards Against Humanity thing, you know, on Internet Explorer. That
oh,
we did.
Wow.
We could do a series on that.
But that would also probably go as about as well as that whole sentence you've just said.
Yeah.
It would have to be live streamed.
The reason why I said it reminded me, because I made, in Cards of Humanity, I actually got the exact same sentence. It was like, I don't know, like, someone misses something, and I put, like, someone misses giant horse robin cock.
What is wrong with you?
A lot of things are
all bad people.
I'm trying to get a screenshot of death here.
Ow.
That's,
okay.
Well, aside from that, I could talk about college, but I can't be asked to talk about my school life, so... Yeah.
Alright, that's fine. So I guess that'll be the end. It's a little shorter than usual, guys, but hopefully it'll suffice. I doubt many of you
are watching. How long is this?
47 minutes? 45 minutes?
Yeah, whoever managed to get to this point in the video, every one of us owe you one singular cookie.
How do
like
you...
I've said this multiple times in videos in the past.
I'll get you a Marilyn cookie with nuts in it. Unless you're allergic to nuts, in which case, sucks to be you, buddy.
But, Rage, you have to be all-including. If one gets it, the whole class must guess it, Rage.
Listen. You can fuck off with your all-including bullshit.
Listen, communism. Nope. Damn it, he moved.
I just watched The Matrix. Alright, well, that's good for us, guys. Let us know about your thoughts on any of the subjects brought up in this video. Let us know what kind of cookie you want. And that's good for us, so thank you, Bionicle.
Let us know in the comments your favorite cookie.
Shadow, and where'd Rage go? I can't hit him. Well, pretend that I'm in Rage.
Problem. Wait, hang on.
Ow.
Get him!
Okay, so thank you guys for watching the video. Thank you guys for joining me. If you guys enjoyed the video, please make sure to like, button, choice, what, and subscribe for more videos just like this one. And if you guys, again, have any thoughts about on any of the stuff that we talked about in this video, go ahead and leave your thoughts in a comment. Keep it civil in comments, but I trust you guys. And I will give you an update eventually on the stuff talked about in the video, such as the Twitter stuff and stuff of the like. So, thank you so much for watching the video. Always remember to keep on crusading. Take care, guys. And goodbye. Let's do this.
For free.
Bye.
Oh, wait, what?
Wow. All right.
Bye. I am the last one alive.